जगदीश यू रेडी?
कैमरा रेडी?
हाँ रेडी, कैमरा रेडी,
रोलिंग,
थ्री टू
वन. Hello and welcome to the Law Jawab Show, where we host formally informal yet candid conversations with the dignitaries. But first, let me tell you that today's episode is a bit off script. It's a candid conversation between a trio discussing their lawyerhood life, as we like to define it. Let me introduce you to my dearest friends, Advocate Konik Kothari and Advocate Shubhankar Avhad. Advocate Konik Kothari, being a first generation lawyer, is independently practicing in the Nasik District Court as well as the Bombay High Court. He has completed his LLB and Masters in Law from NBT Law College with a diploma in Cyber Law. He is also a visiting faculty at MBP Law College. Well, to put it shortly, he is the one-stop solution for all my problems, our version of Better Call Saul, and the most down-to-earth personality I have ever met.
Come on, let's do it, man. Come on.
Our next guest is Advocate Shubhankar Avhad. He has completed his LLB from NBT Law College and Masters in Business Law from Queen Mary's, London, and has worked with M&S Solicitors, London. He has also worked with the top-tier firms of Mumbai, such as MZM and AZB. He has also been a speaker at the United Nations London School of Economics. His research paper was shortlisted at the International Economic Law Conference, St. Petersburg, Russia. He is truly a man of ethics and principle. And I am Sai Savant, working with Special PP Shashir Hire sir, representing the government of Maharashtra in plethora of cases, also a partner at SSH Legal. So, in today's episode, celebrating our season finale, I'll be discussing all the horizons of law practices with the most dearest and the highest achieving people of my life, Advocate Konik Kothari and Advocate Shubhankar Avhad. We'll be discussing how independent practice works, how firm culture works, and how wonderful it is to be associated with a senior.
Dada, wala sang, tumcha law madhe yenacha mool karan ka hota? Why was law your preference? Was law always your preference in the first place?
Actually, no. I was not. See, I don't have a legal background. And I was a 12th science student.
Okay.
Wherein I got, I had to go to PCB, like medical profession. But then somehow things changed. And then that time I was preparing for UPSC also.
Okay.
So one of my friend told me that instead of going for medical, why don't you opt for law? So that way I came into the law. And then for rest is history.
Yes, you're making marvels. What about you?
For me, law was never my first option. I was into sports. I was a cricketer and I was interested in football too. So I was a sports player. Law was my second and safe option, mostly because my father was a lawyer. I had a base, so I had kept it as my safe option. But after a few years when, you know, cricket cannot be your profession for most of the people. So that's what I decided, that now I need to be practical in life, and that's what I turned out to. I turned out to law.
And how is firm practice working for you?
Firm culture, I always wanted to experience the firm culture, and fortunately I got a very good firm. Most of the firms, so most of the firms, they are specialists for some or the other matters. Some firms are specialists for OS matters, some are specialists for arbitration matters. However, my firm, we have specialized in various fields, from white collar crimes to arbitration to original side matters, everything. So we have different partners who look after different departments. And one of the good thing about my firm is that we are not restricted to one partner. So whichever partner needs any associate in any matter, we can work with them. So basically, okay. I can do civil matters, original side matters, I can do white collar crime matters, I can do arbitration, I can do criminal. So yeah, it's an advantage firm culture. You get to work in different forums as well. So yeah.
But see, like I was for my independent practice in my office, so I also get to know many other cases. Like I have many other cases. The one thing which I think in corporate is, or in firm culture, is you get overburdened with work. Or is it not like that?
It's because of the client expectations, to be honest. Because even if a lawyer or my senior knows that this matter is not urgent, but just to fulfill and satisfy the client, they have to meet the
client
deadlines.
Satisfaction is a big thing
in firm culture.
In firm culture,
actually,
also
it is in everywhere.
Practice,
yeah, in my thing also, client has to get. He is the at the end. He is the king.
Yeah, yeah.
But
no.
The thing, one thing about the corporate thing is that when you are dealing with individual people, that person is kind of naive for you.
Okay.
He is not known to legal field. So it is you who is advising him totally.
Okay.
Whereas in corporate culture, the corporate teams which are coming to us, they already have a legal team.
Okay.
So it is their legal team who is advising, you know, the...
Okay,
direction.
So basically corporates are approaching you. So they have their legal team?
They have their legal team.
Yeah.
And through their legal team, they approach us. So the legal team, in order to meet their deadlines or to just to show their company that they are doing work, they force on us.
Okay.
And so we have to meet the deadlines even when it's not needed. So
firm practice is basically a typical 9-to-5 job.
Yeah, kind of.
But you get to go to the court as well.
Mm.
So yeah. But I think the only one thing is that in independent practice, you can do whatever you feel like. You are the king of your own practice or the thing that you want to do.
And I think
in corporate, you have to actually take instructions and do. The only thing is that client based. You get a ready client base in firm practice. Here you have to create your own client.
Exactly.
Base.
Plus the personal development thing.
Yeah.
So like when I have my own office, I have to look into everything.
But it's your own everything.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So what happens
exactly.
is I develop on every point. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Wherein in firm, I think that there's a specific job given to you guys. So few will be into the drafting thing, few will be in the right. Am I right?
Yeah,
sir?
Exactly.
So that way they don't develop in completely. I feel that way.
No, but you learn
but
a lot.
But in the
about
end,
designs.
It depends upon law firm to law firm. So there are certain law firms who just use the new lawyers or associates just for the sake of research drafting.
Okay.
But there are certain firms like my firm that they encourage youngsters to go in the courts to accompany the seniors to client meetings, counsel briefing. And drafting and research as well. So if you get a firm who is ready to provide you each and every platform, so it's kind of good.
Till bachelors, we all belong to almost the same gang, like belong to a certain college together.
Yeah.
And then we had our ways drifted apart. So like for you, for him, for example, he did his LLM from Pune University. You did your LLM from Queen Mary's, London. Can you tell us a little bit about how and the goods and the bads and the everything about it?
See, the LLM in, if we take into point the practice, then LLM is not as such fruitful. Okay.
Yeah.
So it's not like the medical profession where you need to go into PG and do things and all. LLB is sufficient. Okay. LLM is mostly for research oriented things. Like you have to research into the law. It's not that you gain more knowledge of law. It's about the research. And for me, it was practice. So I chose to do it where I stay, where I practice. So while practicing, I could do my master's. And that had an added advantage to me. As later on, due to my master's, I could go into college and I started as a faculty.
Yeah.
So that was my
benefit.
You could
build your own horizons that way.
Yeah. And then I think doing master's outside is a completely different experience. Maybe he'll he'll tell it more properly.
No doubt.
Actually, for me, it was more than anything else, more than the LLM. I always wanted to see the real world because I did my schooling, my junior college, my graduation, all from Nasik. So I thought that I'm suffering from that small town syndrome. So I always wanted to overcome that. And I really wanted to test myself at a bigger stage or at a good level. So in fact, when I got my admission in the law college, I was getting admission in good colleges. Like I was getting admission in GLC. But I didn't go there because I wanted to play cricket in
Nasik.
So my father was really pissed off on me. So, and when it came to doing my LLM, he's like, this time I'm not going to listen. You have to go for the LLM. And so more than me going for the LLM, it was my parents who wanted me to, you know, go out of Nasik and explore the real world. And LLM came as an opportunity for me. And in fortunately, it turned out to be one of the best decisions of my life.
Okay. तो मतलब होमटाउन सिंड्रोम करने के लिए तो लंदन चले जाओगे फ्लाइट पकड़ के मतलब ये तो सही है चीज़ ये तो मतलब बड़े लोग वाली बात है
नथिंग लाइक दैट बट आई ऑलवेज मेनी पीपल आस्क मी दैट व्हाई यू वेस्टिंग योर मनी ऑन एलएलएम
खरा बोल यू आर अ ट्रॅव्हलहॉलिक, यू आर अ वंडर वंडरलस्ट पर्सन, तू फक्त फिरायला गेला होता, देयर वाज नो अदर रीझन, जस्ट एक्सेप्ट इट टुडे.
आय यूज्ड टू सी हिज पोस्ट इन ऑन इंस्टा. He used to post on every different places.
Dude, every
places.
Time he's in different places,
yeah,
in different cities.
Yeah, and I have never seen his one post in college.
Yeah.
Actually,
there's no post.
Actually, the college culture over there is quite different because we have day-to-day colleges. There we had just 2 hours a lecture a day for 3 days and then it's over. Then you have weekly assignments, then you have dissertation, you have your supervision, supervisor having giving you certain deadlines, you have to meet those. So it was more of research than just physically going into the college and attending lectures.
See, this is what real research is.
Yeah.
And we lack that in India, or maybe at least on levels of like Pune University and that thing. So maybe that's the real research. That's the real LLM they do. And if you are doing it, I would suppose if anyone has to do the research thing and all, or go for higher education, they should prefer the options like universities in UK and all.
Yes.
But how does it benefit? See, now our system in India is, you know how our education system works, how it is just the system given 150 years ago, we're just carrying it forward. There was a reason why that system was developed by the Britishers, because they wanted their laborers to be that skilled. But now the scene is different. Yet we are still carrying on the same education thing. And then you all the way shifting that. You being a college professor, you realize this. Now that we have two different aspects here, we can actually compare that. So all the way the breaking out this from this system, going to a new system, coping up, getting the degree and coming back. How was it, and how tedious was it, maybe?
It was a drastic change because I've been here for, I did all my law in Nasik. So here we have a practice that when you have your examination, there are certain important notes.
Yeah.
Or certain, you go through your last year question.
No offense, professor. No offense.
I've been through the same one. I've used notes.
So you have important notes. Then you have last year's question papers. So I thought that, you know, a similar kind of system would be over there. So when the exam time came over there, and we were clueless, especially the people from like my university or the state which I come from. And we were like, how do we prepare for the exam? Because the portion was so...
Exactly.
Because the portion was so vast and there were no important notes.
Yeah.
Notes kidhar hai?
Exactly.
Notes kidhar hai? So, peeli wali book kidhar hai?
Then one of my friend, he went to the professor directly. And he literally asked the question, how do we study for the exam? And he just gave a simple answer. Study the entire syllabus.
Oh, shit.
So, this
very helpful.
So, this is how it works. So, definitely. And because of that, though it was a blessing in disguise. You had to study the whole portion and you go through, you learn new things. So, and this is what we went over there for. We didn't go there for just to get a degree or pass the examination. We went there for...
Not everybody. You went there for your...
I mean, the
I am very sure about it. Nevertheless, I'm sorry. Continue.
So this is how it works, actually.
Yeah. Hmm. Being a professor, listening about this education system of ours, you know, the changes, the disadvantages. I don't think so. There are a lot of people who say only good things about our education system.
Hmm.
It's always on the drawback side. So what... Being a professor, what do you think, what changes are to be brought about?
The thing which right now is going on, which is online classes.
Yeah.
That needs to be scrapped. Because I personally am against it. See, it hampers the teaching as well.
Yeah.
And the learning, I think that on the student point of view, the learning also gets hampered. Because there's no dialogue. See, when I used to teach in class, or like we are having a conversation on a topic. So there's input. On the spontaneous input, like I say something, answers come rightly. I know who is attentive, who is not, and all these things. Now on online lectures, first of all, we tell the students to switch off the audio and video. And then it's only me speaking, and then it doesn't make any sense.
It becomes more monotonous.
I don't even know whether the students are listening, whether they have understood what I'm saying. So sometimes what happens is, in the real class, in the physical way we sit, students sit with a question mark on their face. I automatically come to know that they have not understood anything, or that I have not reached to them. So that time, that's the real point of teaching. What is teaching? you make them understand what you want to tell, what the subject is. Online classes is nowhere close even. Maybe with technology we can improve, but right now it needs to be stopped. That's what I feel.
Exactly. Because the virtual thing, you don't get that feel. Yeah. Because the main thing of a teacher and a student is the interaction.
Exactly.
And in the virtual thing, the interaction is not that much. So I don't know that.
Yeah,
even
in
as
fact,
a student, if today I'm given an option that, you know, attend online classes, I would be like, no. Either I will do.
I'd rather bunk my college.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Not that when we had a physical, like going to the college all the way and coming, not that we attended
all the lectures.
Exactly. But still, this even this online thing is like, ye bhi bunk ho hi jata hai, nahi jamta ye cheez. Anyway, let's move on to my favorite part. Can you please tell me a little bit about your courtroom experiences, whatever has happened until today?
There are many actually. In my last, and see, the juniors, for a junior, everything is new.
Correct.
For a senior, like 10 years down the line, I'll see this incident quite often. So those won't be much funnier for me.
Yeah.
But initially, everything which is said is funnier. There are many, so if I go on telling you this, will take an entire time. But then I'll just tell you one thing. See, what happened was, initially in my years, I used to take all kind of works. Even I take all kind of works today. So I have attended court in Ahmedabad.
Okay.
I've attended court in Rajahmundry, which is in Andhra Pradesh.
Hmm.
Okay. And then I've went to Delhi and all sort of places. In Maharashtra also, I've been in many districts to attend cases. So one such incident happened in Rajahmundry. I had a case there. The client was from Nasik and the suit was filed in Rajahmundry. So we were the defendants. So I had to appear in that matter. I went to Rajahmundry. It is in Andhra and people over there speak only Telugu.
Arre bapre.
In court, when I stepped in, every clerk, every lawyer I met used to speak in Telugu. I didn't know where my court is and where the judge is sitting and nothing I knew. But then I got, I saw a young lawyer. He was my age and then I approached him and he was speaking in English.
Hmm.
So it struck my mind here that time only because everyone was speaking in Telugu. No Hindi, no English. So I told him that could he accompany me in the court so that if anything such happens, then I'll be, he'll be of help.
Some
translation
help.
And exact same thing happened when I went to the court. I appeared and I had presented the 7-11 application, which is the rejection of plate.
Hmm.
So I presented the application. The opposite counsel in that case argued in Telugu. The judge replied in Telugu. And I had no clue what they said. So in that meantime, that guy translated it in English.
Huh.
Then I read it. Then I replied in English. The judge replied in Telugu. The opposite counsel again replied in Telugu. So that was an incident where in that 10 minutes, I was like, okay, this cannot be done. So I came out. That argument was done. It was it was done. And then I came out. I said to him that, I think from here onwards,
you should carry on ahead
because it's very difficult to, mostly in South states, it is very difficult to do it. Similar problem I didn't face in Ahmedabad or Delhi.
Hmm.
But yeah, and I'll tell you one thing here, that though we have one CPC, we have one Evidence Act and we have entire procedure common for all of India, still from place to place, normal procedures change.
Yeah.
There are like just like a language.
Yeah.
Marathi here and Marathi in Vidarbha is different.
Different.
Same with the procedure followed in Nasik is different from procedure followed in Vidarbha. That is a change.
Not even you are talking about states. It differs from district to district.
Yeah, it is. It does.
I have noticed that thing that Mumbai High Court the display board is totally different.
Mm.
Exactly.
And here it is. I don't know what they call it here.
Kharda.
Yeah.
The display board. And it is completely different. It took me almost 2 days to understand where the display board is in the first place.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. So that is
there. But the trial thing. Here is the actual courtroom dramas and everything that you witness. There it's all about just the final stages and everything.
There's one more incident I would like to mention. It was my initial day. Maybe just a month into the court.
Hmm.
Maybe not even the first month, I would say. And then... I appeared, my matter was called my senior's matter was called, and then I went inside. The judge said that your matter is kept for amendment.
Hmm.
And then it was your application and that the order has been passed.
Hmm.
So you have to do the amendment, execute the amendment. So I went out, I called my senior immediately. Sir, sir, so and so has happened. And the judge is saying, I mean, we have to do amendment. And he was in some rush and all. So he just wanted to tell me that we'll do it next time. But he just said, haanti apply karayche nahi. He told me apply karayche nahi. I went inside and I said to judge, amala karayche nahi.
Oh, shit.
It was our amendment application which was allowed. So we were supposed to execute. And I said, sir, amala karayche nahi. So the judge looked at me and like, what this boy is saying? Then he said, I think you should go through
and
the file once again. Call your senior again. Then I called my senior again. He came immediately to tell ki, okay, that's not a thing. We are going to, but on the next date.
Okay.
There are many incidents I will tell you. That's right. If I start telling
exactly.
you. And many funny incidents.
How about
and
you?
Certain incidents we cannot say. Because if anyone from the bar council will hear, they will cancel our channel. So there are certain...
Future.
Exactly. So but many, in fact, we have a session in our law firm when my colleagues, when my friends, they're back from the court.
Yeah.
Everyone goes in their different courts and everyone has their different experiences. So at around like 6 o'clock, when everyone comes back to the office, there is one fixed dialogue.
The gossip section.
Not gossip, actually. This aaj scene ho gaya. Aaj kissa tha. So that is the thing which is, so we just go, we listen.
Yeah.
And it's real fun. In fact, it happened with me in the during my stint with my the current firm. It happened in the first week itself. So there was a case. It was a EOW matter, and my sir, a senior, told me that witness evidence sati aahe. So tu za witness ka yenar nahi. Tu magcha 11 vayas pasna aala nahi aahe. So I just took the file and I went in the court, and the PP is always aware that whether the witness is coming or not. So I just asked the PP casually that witness yet hoega. Tane nahi 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 yete. And I was like, I was a bit relaxed, you know. The witness, you know, I called up my sir. I said that witness is not coming today. Sir told me that she can take the other, no, not adjournment, take the
take
other
the date.
The
yeah.
judge himself will give the date.
Okay.
And so I was pretty relaxed. I was sitting down and the matter was called out. And the judge asked that, has the witness come? And the PP is like, haan sir, aala hai na.
Oh,
and I was like,
shit.
And the matter was for cross-examination. And I was like, dude, we just spoke.
What did you do?
And I was like, so the senior judge told that, nothing doing. Aaj evidence honar. So you have to do the cross, you have to start
oh,
the cross-examination. And I was like, sir, my senior is stuck in Mantralay. He was before a minister. He cannot come today. Like, you start. And I was like, sir, I don't have instructions. They take instructions.
Oh.
So I will finish off the matters and I will start your evidence. Then I called up my senior. I told him, sir, he is going to start the cross-examination today itself. So my sir told me, just don't panic. I will give you certain questions. You frame your own and start the cross-examination. And I did that. And I started the cross because it was very important for me because the matter was quite old. It was a 1988 matter.
Okay.
So that time the person who was the investigating officer, today he was a very senior police officer.
Right.
Oh.
So cross-examining a senior police officer is obviously scary. But I started my cross and in the end I just told them that the final cross-examination and the concluding thing will be done by my senior. And that's how it went. So... It's always the courtroom experience are always expect
always
the unexpected. It's
it
always expect the unexpected.
Yeah, definitely.
The lawyers always have to be on the edges.
Exactly.
You never know what's going to happen.
Exactly.
You just can have that in your mind that, okay, these things can happen.
And one more thing happened that not only just bad experiences, but there are certain good experiences as well. So we had a CBI matter and we had to file the reply. But the reply was not ready because we had no authority from the client and we didn't have instructions from the client. But sir told me that seek an adjournment in that date. But I told that, you know, last three occasions we had sought an adjournment on the similar grounds. This time the justice will grill us. And sir told me that no, just go and mention them. I was like, okay. And I went to the court and the SPP was present. So I got more scared because if he presses for that, the judge will grill me. So, as soon as the matter was called out, I started pleading to the court. So, the justice were like, what you want? I said that we need 1 week's time to file the reply. And to the surprise of everyone, the justice was so good that she's like, 1 week, I give you 3 weeks time to file a reply. So, because she literally saw me scared and she was, I was panicking. So she told me that take 3 weeks time for filing the reply. So it's not always the bad experiences, but certain justices, judges are really understanding and they really understand the juniors well.
In fact, even I have seen this, ki, when they realize, when they बघितल्या कळतं की दिस इज अ ज्युनियर एज अ सिनियर इज सेंट हिम ऑन सम स्मॉल इन्स्ट्रक्शन्स अँड ही इज ट्राइंग टू फंबल अँड ट्राई टू स्पीक समथिंग देर आर सम जस्टिसेस हू अंडरस्टँड अँड लाइक ओके लेट्स
दैट इज द ट्रिक सो दैट इज द ट्रिक व्हेन अ सीनियर लॉयर वांट्स एन अडजमेंट ही सेंड्स हिज ज्युनियर इवन व्हेन ही इज फ्री सो दैट इज हाउ थिंग्स वर्क
I don't know, but every office has that one person who just goes and takes dates and comes
date specialist.
No, in fact,
that's the only date that he's getting.
No, but there is... So in high court, there is, you are talking about a person in a chamber. In the high court, there is a person who is an adjournment specialist. So he's a freelancer adjournment specialist.
Okay.
Any lawyer, any law firm, if they need an adjournment.
I didn't know this was a real thing.
It's for real.
He has made a career out of
adjournment. Yeah, exactly.
Out of adjournment.
And he has taken adjournment on with judges who are really shrewd for giving adjournments. And that's why he's called the adjournment specialist.
But he's got, I think, manla bhai jaisa log, exactly. He's got out a career of like something that is that has nothing to do with.
Exactly.
He's got a career,
he's
out,
career
of
out of it. So.
He's the getaway card.
That's nice. You have also done this petty work like us, the Xeroxing and running from this court to that court, servicing. You know those.
जूनियर वी फील यार ये क्या कर रहे हैं ये यार ये लॉ चाहिए अपने को ऐसा बट दैट्स नॉट अ थिंग अनलेस यू लर्न दिस यू डोंट गेट टू डू दैट बिकॉज दिस इज द ग्राउंड विदाउट दिस दैट्स नथिंग
Yeah.
You need
actually,
to do.
Actually, it's real fun carrying the briefs of the seniors, accompanying him.
Dude, it's so gym. You don't need to go to gym separately. Dude, I had... Okay, so I was the shortest person in my office. And all my seniors are quite tall and they walk very fast. And me carrying... Sometimes I used to have their gowns. Sometimes those briefs. And I'm running. Especially wo jo church gate ka rasta and that.
Yeah.
It's very weird. That this, place is not good for running and stuff. And these guys are nicely talking on the phone and fatafat. And I'm like, so one day I was like, tum na mere chote chote kadmo ka na kuch matlab kadar hi nahi karte ho. So us pe my senior laughed so much. In fact, till today they point out that, okay, we'll walk slow for you. I think that was also very
understanding. But actually the culture is changing because today
it's
I'm seeing...
friendly.
No, not friendly, but today I'm seeing juniors who have just passed out from universities. Yeah. They're reluctant to do such kind of work. They directly want matters.
Yeah.
They would be happy to do the research work, but not this kind of things.
But like that is there, but in Nasik, you would need to do the groundwork.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Because then you get to know the time management thing.
Hmm.
That's a skill which you develop here. Because you have to do the groundwork fatafat.
Exactly.
Hmm.
That's why you develop contacts.
Yes.
Okay, you develop a work of chain. You meet the clerk. You develop a rapport with him so that your work gets
thing.
yeah that's what I'm saying.
In fact, knowing clerks is more important
more
than
important
knowing
lawyers. Yes, exactly. So what happens is abhi mujhe first day I get 2 hours for that work. Tomorrow I develop a rapport with the clerk, he does my work, so it takes only 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So that remaining 1 hour 45 minutes I get to spend on the legal matter.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And if that habit is what we call in court
discipline.
Yes, no doubt. I think everyone should have that one person who knows a person.
Exactly.
Whatever the job is to be done.
The most
that's
important
better
thing.
Call Saul.
That's you better
need,
call
that
Saul.
Lawyer needs to know people.
You need to know people. Yeah.
I know a guy who knows a guy.
Yeah.
Exactly. One in the court, one in the filing section.
Exactly.
These two people are needed.
But clerks teach you more than maybe because they see. I personally feel that rather than just going in the courtrooms and sitting and listening to the matters, hearing, go behind a clerk. See what he is doing. Just go and assist him. I think that is where you learn more. How the filing is done, how the corrections or the amendments or the objections are done.
No doubt.
That's where we learn half of the procedure.
Yeah, exactly. Definitely.
Half of the CPC, I would say. The execution, see, judge orders, the lawyer argues. That is the cream part. But what next?
Yes.
There's the execution part.
Execution part.
Execution of amendment, then taking the orders, taking the court files to AS. And this part, we get to know how the things change, how things work, how files get transferred and all. That is very important.
Important.
I think law is about not what it is, but how it is done.
Exactly.
The how word is more important.
How is very important.
That is where you learn it only on the ground level.
And that's how you learn the loopholes.
Yeah.
Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the next episode for more such fun conversations. Stay tuned. Stay Lajawab.